Master.
So it may be impossible to remember events of 50 years ago, but what was your relationship to Godspell author John MIchael Tebelak at Carnegie Mellon, and what was the circumstance of you being approached to participate in the development?
Well, and I was in the drama department at CMU, and I think I was a junior at the time, and we weren't so much approached for roles, but what would happen is John MIchael was a directing major as a master's student. So it was his part, one of his projects was to put together, a production. And he would be given a pool of actors, probably sophomore through senior.
Okay.
And I remember walking down the hall at the Fine Arts Building one day with my friend at the time, well, still, Sonia Manzano. And we knew the casting stuff was going to start to go up. And we looked at the board and we saw John MIchael Tebelak and saw this thing, Godspell. And we looked over at what we thought were the main stage productions, the big guy productions,
right.
Didn't see our names. And then we looked at John MIchael's and she went, oh my God, look, I'm clown number 7. And I looked and went, oh my God, I'm clown number 3. What does this even mean? So that was how we started.
That's beautiful, man. Can't find that in Wikipedia.
No, you can't.
When the show moved to New York, there was another score attached with different songs. Why didn't that iteration of the show work? And what was the process that brought Stephen Schwartz to write the now classic score?
Yeah. Well, at CMU, and we only had about 3 or 4 shows.
Okay.
That was it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
And we did it in a small, what they called the studio theater, which held about 60 people. I will mention that word got around very quickly around the whole campus.
Cool.
So that by the 4th show, the last show, people couldn't get into the studio. So it was packed. But a few months later, John MIchael decided to approach the Café La Mama, which is an off Broadway theater in New York City. And they wanted to put on the show. At the time we had music that had been written by one of the musicians in the local band.
Okay.
And it was new, certainly for CMU, to do a musical, especially a musical based on the gospel according to St. Matthew, but it wasn't a rousing score. It had some interesting elements to it, but it wasn't very professional.
Okay.
But it worked at Café La Mama and certainly got our producers interested in the show. But they felt also that this music wasn't working as well as it might. So they brought Stephen Schwartz down to the Café La Mama and said, do you think you could write a new score for the show? And he said, yeah, I think I could. And they said, do you think you could do it in 4 weeks? And he did.
Amazing.
He did. Yeah. A few of us went back to Carnegie thinking, we'll just go back to our studies.
Right.
And then we got a few weeks later, we got a call. Do you want to come and do it and open off Broadway?
Oh, man.
With a new score.
So what was it about the timbre of your voice that made it right for your character to sing Day by Day? And what was behind the decision to list the single as Godspell rather than your voice? Was it out of your hands?
Well, there were almost everybody in our original company could sing.
Okay.
Not like Broadway actors today, except for Joanne Jonas, who had a lovely voice. I hadn't sung very much. I'd sort of done my own, things. I played a little guitar and a little piano. You'd have to ask Stephen Schwartz, but I think he just matched up the songs to the characters and probably to the vocal qualities. And Day by Day was a very simple kind of heartfelt song, and maybe he felt my voice was right for it.
Well, maybe emotionally you were right for it too. That's always a thing. So you obviously went to number 13 on the charts, and you're hearing your, when did you hear yourself on the radio for the first time?
It was a little unusual.
What was your own religiosity at the time of developing Godspell? Did you become more faithful because of this deep dive into the Jesus story, or was it unaffecting to you?
I can't say it was unaffecting. I've never been super religious. I think I'm kind of a spiritual person. And I did grow up singing in choirs in Brooklyn Heights.
Nice.
But I think mostly because I was very drawn to the music rather than the message. But I can't say it was unaffecting. To repeat that message every night and to believe in it, which I think as an actor, you need to invest yourself in that. I think it does affect you, and it makes you feel like trying to be a good person, I think.
It's beautiful, beautiful. What in your audition for film director David Green secured you the movie role? What was most difficult for you in the stage to film acting transition?
I did not have to audition.
Oh, great. Of course you didn't.
I don't really know the process. We were not privy to right. the process. I know that David Green and Columbia Pictures, they went to see every production of Godspell.
Yes.
From the national companies to, I know they considered actors from London and certainly Canada. My understanding, and this is again very, very vague, was that David Green was interested in someone else to sing Day by Day. Hmm. And at that point, Stephen Schwartz and John MIchael Tebelak said, absolutely not. So I think they put their foot down and that was offered the role.
How about that stage to film transition? You were doing your first movie, obviously. How did that, was that difficult or did you adapt pretty readily?
No, it wasn't difficult at all. I think doing the film was so much fun, I have to say. Even in the difficult moments of waiting all day for the right shot, or certainly a couple of locations I was not particularly comfortable.
Right, we'll talk about that.
Yes.
It seemed to me you did some incredibly difficult stunt work in the film. The fishing boat comes to mind, and of course, the dance on top of the North Twin Tower.
Yeah.
What do you remember about those particular scenes?
The boat I loved, because I love being on the water, so I had no issue with that.
Okay.
The World Trade Center was a different story. I do not like heights.
Oh, my.
And as I recall, neither building was totally finished at that time. So we had to take an elevator up and then climb the next 8 stories by ladder.
Oh my God.
And certainly by ladder to the roof. And I was not particularly happy up there.
This is Patrick McDonald for HollywoodChicago.com. Copyright 2021.